Hello, I am Mangesh Kadam. We are going to discuss nature of ideology. In the earlier portion, we had already discussed meaning of ideology, in which we discussed ideology as a set of ideas and ideology as a science of idea that we had already discussed. However, by analyzing ideas, we can say that there are three important dimensions for ideologies, and those are empirical dimension. This empirical dimension is also known as descriptive dimension. Another dimension is normative dimension, and that is also known as prescriptive dimension. And third dimension is operative dimension or practical. The first dimension, that is known as empirical dimension, always believes that ideology provides lens to understand surrounding, to understand society, to understand whole world. So how do you understand whole world? You can understand the existing system, existing social order. So, ideology always describes the society. What is the exact nature of the society? What are the different pattern of interaction? For example, liberal ideas would explain economic activity from different perspective by saying that every individual has a right to compete in a particular system of production, to earn more and more money, get more and more profit. Rather, socialist understanding would understand the economic activity from very different perspective by saying that economic activity itself is exploitative because it is being dominated by those people, those who are having control over means of production. The ideology would always criticize, will always examine the existing social order. In that sense, it will either criticize or it will prescribe, it will try to prescribe different kind of ideas as well. So ideologies are always based on facts. Ideologies always talks about what is. This empirical dimension of ideology talks about what is. Empirical dimension of ideology talks about what is the exact situation, what are the different facts. So this is second important dimension is normative. So normative dimension is also considered as prescriptive in nature. Ideology prescribes some values to the society. For example, liberal ideology prescribes free society as a value. Socialist ideologies prescribe proletariat control over state machinery and classless society. So these ideologies are also prescribed particular form of government, who should rule, what should be the structure of government, how the rules should be enacted, drafted, created and implemented. For example, liberal would say that democratic form of government is the best form of government. People's representation or representative form of government is the best form of government. Socialist would say that dictatorship of proletariat would benefit people at large scale. Third dimension is operative dimension or practical dimension. So whatever is been empirically studied by ideologue or ideology, and whatever particular values had been prescribed as an ideal value, ideal society, how that ideal society, ideal values could be achieved. So ideology always comes with particular proactive or active role by setting some strategies. For example, how that liberal society or free society could be achieved. So liberalism would give particular set of strategies, like for example, election or a democratic form of government, representative form of government, political parties. All these things would lead to particular ideal society. In that sense, political ideologies always lead to particular kind of social movement, particular kind of movement within the community, within the followers, and those followers would follow that particular ideas and will act toward establish or whatever ideal has been prescribed that particular ideology. Hence, in that sense, political ideology is always action. Apart from these three dimensions, the important thing with respect to nature of ideology is that nature of ideologies have become hybrid in nature, or cross-cutting ideologies had also been emerged during the period of globalization, or during the period after the period of the battle of communism. Another understanding says that ideas can be understood as amalgamation of different set of ideas, or the ideas always overlaps with each other, and ideas are fluid in nature. It's not closed system. For example, Michael Friedan talks about morphology of ideology. Michael Friedan says that the ideologies are consist of different kind of set of ideas. For example, liberal conservatism. So liberal conservatism is consist of liberalism as well as conservative, or social feminism, socialism and feminism. So Michael Friedan's ideologies are amalgamation of different ideas as well. So, for example, the conventional ideologies, liberalism, Marxism, communism, are also getting changed, and there are emergence of different kind of ideologies which are based on amalgamation of different ideas from different established or conventional ideologies. And that's why we can differentiate ideologies between conventional ideologies or thick ideologies and thin ideologies. Thick ideologies are very traditional in nature. Thick ideologies are liberalism, socialism, feminism or communism. And thin ideology would be liberal conservatism, socialist feminism. The nature of ideologies had always been changing. And this is because of globalization, because of changing nature of class structures in the society, because of debacle or the because of defeat of communism. The defeat of communism or the disintegration of USSR, the globalization period and creation of new different classes like not only working class or capitalist class, but managerial class, technocratic class, all had led to different kind of classes in the society as well. So, for example, feminism as an ideology cannot appeal all feminist or all feminist thought. For example, that's why there had been creation of black feminism, Dalit feminism. So, at the end, what I wanted to say is that ideologies are not very close in nature. Ideologies are also amalgamation of different set of ideas, what had been discussed by freedom. Thank you so much for listening.